In this short video, we will learn a typical after takeoff flow. The flow is accomplished once the gear has been retracted and the flaps are up fully. The first thing we check is therefore that the gear is up and the lights extinguished. Next, the check the flap handle is at zero, and the gauge also shows the flaps are in fact up. We can now move the landing gear lever to the off position. Next, we once again check the flaps are up, and the leading edge flap's transit light is not illuminated. Moving across, the auto brake switch is turned to off, deactivating the system. On the bleed air control panel, we check the pack switches are in the auto position, and the engine bleed air switches are set to on. We now check the differential pressure, indicated on the outer scale, is increasing. The differential pressure on the gauge indicates the pressure is currently 5.8 psi. Glancing up, we check the anti-icing switches are set as needed. We turn our attention to the APU and check it is running or not running as required. Finally, we check that the fuel is balanced before running the checklist. We will now view the flow from both the captain and first officer's viewpoint in real time. The captain checks the gear and flaps are up. Moves the gear handle to off. Checks the flaps are up, no light, and turns the auto brake switch to off. Checks the packs are in auto, and engine bleeds are on. Checks differential pressure is increasing. Anti-ice switches are set as required. And the APU is also as required. Once the fuel balance is checked, the checklist can be run. Let's now observe the flow from the first officer's perspective, without voiceover. We hope you enjoyed learning about the after takeoff flow and seeing it from both pilots' perspective. Please subscribe to learn of our future tutorials.